one of the first videos I made for this channel walked you through creating a temperature controlled fan using ESPHome. Since then, I thought I could do a bit better, so I've made a number of improvements and come up with a super deluxe version of my USB fan controller. If you haven't seen the first video, then you should check it out. I'll put a link up there and down in the description. So, why am I creating a better version then? Well, let's start with the hardware. The original version was just bodged together and stuck inside an old battery case with a USB cable sticking out of it and the transistor protected by insulation tape. It really wasn't very pretty. I decided to stick all of the components on a breadboard, soldering them all in place. I chose a D1 mini this time with an ESP8266 chipset instead of the ESP32 I used before. The D1 mini is a bit cheaper, smaller, and has just about enough connection points for this project. Instead of a USB cable, I used an actual USB socket and soldered it to the breadboard. The temperature sensor is the same, although I used a BME280 instead of a BMP280. You can use whichever one you manage to get hold of, just remember to change the letter in the configuration later. I also decided to fit an RGB LED. The one I used is a 5mm common cathode LED, and I can use that to display status alerts. Once all of the components are on the board, I needed to connect them all up. And this is the wiring diagram for this project. One thing to point out here is that all of those black wires are terminating on the ground pin of the D1 Mini. From a diagram perspective, this is perfectly fine, but in real life, having all of those cables soldered to the same pin is a bit of a nightmare. I soldered a separate header pin to the breadboard, away from the microcontroller, just to give me plenty of space to solder it. And here's the finished product, showing you the top with the components and the underside with all of the wires. I think it's a lot neater than the original version already. And now to the software. The biggest issue with the original version was its reliance on Home Assistant. If your Wi-Fi went down or Home Assistant went down, then the fan would stop running because all of the logic was in Home Assistant. Well, this deluxe version moves all of that fan control logic inside the microcontroller. It'll totally run autonomously, even if it loses its network connection. Now, this fan is going in the IT cabinet in my garage, so it's called IT Cabinet Fan. At the top of the config, I've defined a couple of parameters. You can tweak any of these. The description and the names you should customize as you see fit. The two temperature thresholds should be changed to meet your requirements. The top value defines the temperature at which the fan will turn on, and the bottom value is the temperature that the fan will turn off. You'll probably want them close, but not the same. If you're using my wiring diagram, then you shouldn't need to change anything else. But just to quickly run you through the rest of the config, if I scroll down to this section here, this defines the pins used by the temperature sensor. You can see I'm using pins 4 and 5. Then we have a section to define the pins used by the LED. And now we have a clever section, which is the temperature sensor. Note that the platform says BME280 for me, but if you get a BMP280 instead, then change that here. There's an action associated with the temperature sensor that executes when the sensor value rises above the top threshold or drops below the bottom threshold. It turns on or off the fan switch object as appropriate. That fan switch object is the next item to discuss. It's a GPIO switch using pin D5. Note that this switch is declared as internal, which means that Home Assistant can't see it. That's because we don't want it to be manually controlled. Instead, we define a binary sensor a few lines later. This binary sensor essentially mirrors the state of the fan, so Home Assistant sees this binary sensor instead of the switch, and you can view its status but not control it. Lastly, we have the RGB LED. This section sets the light entity and makes sure that it's internal only. Then this interval section here runs every 3 seconds. It checks to see if the fan switch is off, and if so, it just slowly pulses the LED green. This is intended as a kind of confirmation of standby. If, however, the fan switch is on, it sets the LED to solid red. This status LED could be quite useful for testing without a fan connected, because it should tell you what the USB port status is. Once configured, it's time to test it. Connect it all together with your chosen USB fan. This time I'm using a 120mm Elateng USB fan. Now, to test it, you need a way to apply controlled heat to the temperature sensor. I found that the best way to test it is with a travel hairdryer. At the moment, the fan is off and the temperature sensor is below the threshold. You can see the green LED pulsing on and off. But if I apply a bit of heat, you should see it turn on. And it's on. See, the LED has turned red now too. Now, we just need to wait a minute or two for the temperature to drop and the sensor to turn the fan off. Yay, look, it works. See, the green LED is now pulsing away, meaning the fan has shut off. There is one final task. This project needs a case. Now, I know I've left this to last, but I had of course planned the layout and size from the start. Make sure you have a suitably sized project enclosure and cut your breadboard to size before you start. I've cut out a hole for the micro USB power, another for the USB port for the fan, and I drilled a hole for the LED. Notice that I've also drilled a few smaller holes around by the temperature sensor to allow a bit of airflow, which hopefully will give me a bit more of an accurate reading. Well, I hope you enjoyed seeing this little project. I know there's more soldering and effort than the previous version, but I think you'll agree that this is a much neater solution and generally improved all round. I'll stick the wiring diagram and device configuration up on my website for you to look at, along with a parts list in case you want to give it a go yourself, and I'll stick a link to that article down in the description. If you like this video, then please give it a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.